So what's up guys, I'm Mesh from TechMesh and hope you are doing well. So today I'm going to show you that how you can fix your Windows 10 laptop power stays on after shutting down or your Windows 10 won't shut down properly. Okay, so I will show you all the solutions. So before getting started, I would suggest you to please hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more future videos like this one. So let's get started, shall we? So your Windows 10 won't shut down. This problem can occur for many types of reasons and there are variety of solutions available. Okay, so one solution might work for you and another solution might work for another person and not work for you. So I will show you all the possible solutions. So let's start with the first one. This is the solution where most people will get their problem fixed. Okay, this is the most common solution. So what you need to do is you need to just right click on your battery icon, okay, and then here just click on power options. So in your power option, then just click on choose what the buttons do. So here you need to just uncheck this box, turn on fast startup. You need to just uncheck it, okay. So to uncheck it, just click on change settings that are currently unavailable. Just click on here, and then here you need to just click on here, okay. You need to just uncheck this box, turn on fast startup, okay. So then just click on save changes and then restart your computer, and then let's check that if your problem is fixed or not. If it fixes your problem, then don't forget to hit the like button, okay. So the next solution is you need to update your Intel management engine interface, okay. Just right click on here on your start button, and then here just click on device manager, okay. Just click on device manager. So in your device manager, just click on system devices. You will see system devices. Just click on here. So here you will find your Intel ARM management engine interface. Just click on here. Okay. So here you need to just check its version. Okay. So just let me show you. Just go to driver and here you will find driver version. So if your driver version is 9.5 or above that, like in my case it is 11.0, okay. So if you have 9.5 or above that, then you don't need to follow the next procedure or this step, okay. You can skip this step. And if you have a version below 9.5, then you need to update it. So I will show you how you can update this version, okay. Just go to your Google Chrome and then search for Intel Management Engine Interface 9.5 for Windows 10. Okay. And then you need to obviously search your device manufacturer. Like in my case, it is an Asus laptop. So I will search for Asus. Okay. So then you need to just download it and then just click on update driver. Okay. Just click on update driver and then just click on browse my computer for software. And then you need to just update it. Okay. So after updating, don't forget to restart your computer and let's check your problem is fixed or not. Okay. So let's go to the third solution, which is you need to just open your command prompt. Okay. Just here type for CMD. So you would find your command prompt. So you need to just click on run as administrator. Okay. Just right click on your CMD and then click on run as administrator. This is a definite must. If you don't select it, run as administrator, then your program won't work. Okay. So here you need to type this following command. Okay. Just type for power cfg.exe /hibernate /off. You need to just turn off your hibernate, okay. If you have turned on or turned off your hibernate, then do the opposite, okay. If you have turned on your hibernate, then turn it off. So then just cross it, okay. So that's how you can turn off your hibernate and then restart your computer and check if your problem is fixed or not. And if it still didn't fix your problem, then just again go to CMD, then again open CMD as administrator and type the command. Now just turn it on. So now just type this following command and click on enter, and now just turn on the hibernate and then try hibernate once and then restart your device and let's check your problem, if your problem is fixed or not. Okay, so this was the method 3. So if it fixed your problem, then don't forget to hit the like button. So the fourth method is boot order. You need to just go to your BIOS. So just turn off your computer and then just turn it on and then keep pressing your boot menu key. I will put some common boot menu key in the description below. So after going to your BIOS, then here just go to your boot option. Okay. So in your BIOS, what you need to do is you need to here you will find your default order. You need to just restore your default order and then press yes. Okay. Then you need to just save it and exit. Okay, just here you will find at the bottom, or as you can see in my case it is here. So then just press F10 on, or in your case the keys could be different. Okay, so it varies from laptop to laptop. So that's how you can fix your Windows 10 laptop power light stays on after shutting down. And if you still have any question or if it didn't work for you, then don't forget to let me know that in the comment section below, and keep an eye on my description, because if I find any new method, then I would obviously put that in the description, the link in the description. And if it works for you, then don't forget to hit the like button and let me know that in the comment section below, and let others know that this method actually works. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon and watch my other videos as well. So I'm Mesh from TechMesh and I'm signing out. Thank you.